Aber ein herzliches Willkommen unter Nutzer weiter Part Let's Play Fake Grand Order. Ich bin der SimSmurfix. Wir sind hier wieder in dem vierten Lost Belt. Beim letzten Mal haben wir die Wahl erreicht, wo uns Lakshmi Bey begrüßt hat. Die werte Dame ist hier die Anführerin einer Rebellenarmee, die gegen den falschen Gott, wie sie ihn selber nennen, hier entgegensteht. Und nach einigen hier hin und her hat sie nun erkannt, dass wir ebenfalls gegen diesen sind. Und die Frage ist natürlich nun, ob wir uns mit der werten Dame zusammentun, um hier gegen Arjuna Alter zu kämpfen. Fufu! Lakshmi Bey?
I would like to think that anyone would be a bit embarrassed to recount the history of their own life. No matter how proud of that life they may be. So that's why Holmes has been so unusually quiet, huh? Alright then, I guess I'll...
Lakshmi Bey is a hero from the 19th century in Indri, known for her role in the Indian Rebellion.
Oh, thanks for jumping in, Captain. Why don't you take it from here?
Despite being born from a royalty, she took up a sword and led a small rebel army in order to protect the nation of Jhansi. She was known far and wide for her leadership and charisma. At the time, revolts were breaking out all across India under all men of different circumstances. When one small state tried to revolt, the neighboring nation would often end up siding with the British. Isolating the rebels and cutting them off from working with like-minded people in other regions. But the Jhansi rebels managed to hold out until the very end. And it was all thanks to the exceptional leader, Lakshmi Bey.
I won't call myself exceptional. I was just flailing around trying to hold everything together as best as I could. Between Kuvara Singh, Taita Top and many others could name, there were no end of leaders more talented than me. On the other side, you sound like you know a lot about our struggle. Are you Indian yourself?
I'm nobody, just another nameless. It doesn't matter where I'm from, I'm done now. I went out.
Why, we added, we should probably also go over your divine spirit, Lakshmi. Damn sure Ganesha and Rama know a lot more about her than I do. In Indian mythology, Lakshmi is known as the goddess of fortune, prosperity, beauty and...
Und natürlich die Ursprung von Sita.
And a consort of Vishnu, right?
That's right.
Then, could it be? I'm an avatar of Vishnu, and Sita an avatar of Lakshmi. Sita, are you in there? I'm sure if you are, I'll be able to feel your presence. I'm guessing this is clear to all of you as well, given that her grip on my skull is strong enough to the bones are starting to crack. But unfortunately, I sense no trace of Sita inside her.
Why is this man advancing on a woman he's never met before, as if he proposed to her?
Do you mind if I break him?
No. I understand how you feel, but please go easy on him. Rama has his own complicated history.
I see. So I suppose I can't blame you for this misunderstanding. I should have been more precise. The goddess Lakshmi exists within me more as a power source than anything else. I can barely sense her consciousness at all. It's almost as though her heart has been implanted in me to provide me with energy. I hope my output can measure up to that unadulterated divine spirit. So I'm afraid I'm not the manifestation of the goddess Lakshmi so much as my core is that human Rani Lakshmi Bey. The small elements of the goddess.
Und ist Rama jetzt gebrochen? Rama ist tot. Okay, gut.
Then Sita really doesn't exist inside you, as I suspected, right? Of course she doesn't. Now that I think about it, if she had, I would have sensed her well before you introduced yourself. But I was not even able to tell that the deity within you slashed me. You must have only her divine power and nothing of her consciousness.
Ganesha didn't realize who you were either.
Of course that might be because he was never very close to you, seeing as how you're just us up here in the pantheon as his mom, Parvati.
Ganesha?
Yes, now that I mentioned it, I do sense a divine presence inside you. One I would never in a million years have guessed by looking at you.
Yeah, I know that.
But it's true, believe me. I spent pretty much the entire time wishing all this were just some weird joke.
And I'm Rama, the king of Kosala. Sure you have heard of me, as well as my beloved Sita?
Oh, of course! There's not a soul in India who doesn't know your name.
Forgive me.
I
thought you were just an unusual youthful man. Why hadn't I yet learned how to behave around women?
Der war gut. Maybe not a good time to share your side.
Good point. We have a bunch of things we need to tell you about. Who we are, how we got here, and what we're trying to do. It's a long story, but I hope you'll bear with us.
Ich will immer noch wissen, wie sie beim letzten Mal den Reset hier überlebt hat. Das ist eigentlich meine Hauptfrage immer noch.
And I think that about sums it up. Hold it! Hold it! What about me? I thought you were saving the most important figure in our group for the end, as to make the lasting impression.
Yes, this is Call of Music. Absolutely positive, we definitely didn't forget to introduce.
Nope.
As you can probably tell from his sheer gif, I mean his dignified stature, he's a commander-in-chief.
Haha, indeed I am. A stout build is the mark of a true elite, after all. As the commander officer here, I expect you to treat me with all due respect.
I have one question for you. Are you British?
No, I'm not.
What about you?
Me? What would be telling, hon? You've got to get to know me better first. I suppose I can at least tell you that no, I'm not British either. I did spend a good time at the clock tower.
Oh boy. Well, there's one last person in our group I should introduce you to.
Uh-oh, Sherlock!
Sorry, Holmes, the trick is up. You can't keep hiding forever.
Oh mein Gott, Mann! Ja, so krass, Mann! Leute, Mann, wieso hat er sich die ganze Zeit nicht gemeldet, weil er... Die natürlich gekämpft hat. Natürlich, es muss Luxury Bay sein. Ich spüre sie in der Präsenz. Oh, die wird eine Konfrontation mit einem Briten haben. Deswegen verstecke ich mich. Leute, der ist so krass, Mann.
I assure you, I was doing no such thing. I was only waiting for a more opportune moment once things had settled down.
Good day, Miss Luxury Bay. Sherlock Holmes, detective at your service.
Are you British?
Yes, I am.
Is that a problem?
The Indian Rebellion was, well, it was a war for India's independence against its colonizers, the British. And since Lakshmi Bai lost her life in the conflict, I imagine she has some strong feelings about it.
Though I do get the impression there's someone else who here with her connection to that.
Ah well, guessing it's not my place to say anything here.
I was only a few years old when the war broke out. So while I can't personally apologize for my country's action.
That's alright, I'm sorry, that was rude of me.
There's a little sense in asking that. It's just an old habit, one I can't seem to shake.
You have nothing to apologize for. It's not for me to say whether you should or shouldn't feel that way. Nor is it for me to say whether you should hold onto those feelings or try to forget them. All I can say for sure is that our country's histories are intertwined. Certainly, neither of us can pretend otherwise. If this hadn't come up now, Maxie would no doubt have noticed the air of discomfort between us, and gone to learn what happened between our countries for himself. If there's any meaning to be found by having people from the past come all together like this, besides the role we play as servants, of course, I suspect it lies there.
Agreed. I think of you as a more than a man by the name of Sherlock Holmes. Besides other circumstances, the more allies we have, the better.
Then, does that mean you consider us allies?
It was difficult to convince the people of Dival of the wrongness of the situation, but once I did, they agreed to work together to forge our own destiny. Their village here is not a base for all the like-minded people. As your warriors fighting against a god just like us, I'd be honored if you fought to our side.
It's a deal!
I guess the counterforce must have summoned you, too. Have you been here long?
Yes. I'd say it's been at least 10 days since I arrived.
Then you must have been caught in the world's reaction, recreation a number of times. How did you survive?
God or not, remaking this entire lost bit is a major undertaking.
Arjuna wouldn't change how he goes about it just because a servant's been added to the mix.
So long as he doesn't think of an unnecessary defective, I expect he'd just bring you back along with all the other people.
It's just got me thinking how our survival in this lost belt is completely dependent on his absurdly absurdity standards. It's natural for gods to be somewhat self-centered given their immense power, but a druid definitely takes it to the far.
Oh, speaking of which, you should know he's already got his eye on us. So if you join us, you're sure to wind up with the whole evil label. You won't be able to survive the world being remade anymore.
That's fine. It could only have been a matter of time before they took notice of me anyway. Besides, you have a way to evade the destruction, yes? So if it comes to that, I'll be counting on your help.
You mean the border? Yes, of course, you'd be welcome to join us in here, wouldn't you?
The borders is the last bastion of hope for all of humanity. We can't just go letting any old servant we met in on it. Under any circumstances anyway. But in this case, I suppose we do have a fair handle on the true name and background. And it would be a shame to lose a valuable ally so soon after finding one. Well, out is your entry into the border in case of emergency.
You have my gratitude.
Ha ha ha, Musik. Of course, I only hope to be quite finished with this place long before we even uses the purpose of the noble phantasm office again.
You said it, honey. Fortunately, we only have a dust at the end of the Kali Yuga.
So it would be just peachy if we could put a stop to all this before then.
Now that we have got a new ally and all, what's our next step?
I've already got something in mind for that. There are risks involved, naturally. But the reward should be significant. Entweder der sehr seltsame Würfel oder die anderen Servants finden. Die Bösartigen, die La Kalpa. Now that we're in the middle of the first relatively peaceful Yuga, and especially now that we've more allies, this would seem like the perfect time to investigate the thing in particular.
What's that? Ah, der Cube! Sag ich doch.
Haha, remember that thing we've been wondering about ever since we come to this lost belt?
It's the biggest, most mysterious thing here by far, and it's got to contain some useful information. Now we want you guys to finally go and investigate it.
Got Sky Boulder.
Das kleine, unscheinbare Ding, was da am Himmel schwebt. Was man so gar nicht sieht. Ein Quartz. Ich hakte so viel Quartz aus, liebe Leute. Schon wieder über 300 Quartz für Scotty ausgeben. No, Scotty! Leider. Aber okay. Dafür sammeln wir hier wieder. Okay.
So, wo ist The Brightest Bright? Oh, eigentlich war es interessant, mit Lakshmi Bay zu spielen. Aber, nö.
Ja, da bin ich jetzt eigentlich, liebe Leute. Ich möchte hier Unlimited Ishtapor zeigen.
All hail to best goddess. Section 9. Gods Skyboulder.
Ich sag ja, dieser kleine, unscheinbare Rubik's Cube, der da am Himmel ist. Wenn wir ihn richtig drehen, liebe Leute, dann geht es. Okay, oh nein. Wir sagen, den Tag ist so schnell vorbei! Okay, das schaffen wir definitiv nicht vom nächsten Reset.
So, I don't know what Skyboulder is either, then, Lakshmi.
No, I don't. It was there when I first was summoned here, and it hasn't changed at all in the time since. At least I don't think it has. I haven't been watching it the whole time, so I can't say for certain.
Well, I have been watching it this whole time, so I can. It definitely never changed.
Das heißt, ja, was auch nicht, was ist. Since we haven't actually asked, you don't know what it is either, correct?
That's right, I just noticed there was a big weird cube in this lost bed and didn't think anything more of it.
Okay, why is there a monster cube that rumfliegt? Stell dir nicht.
I mean, sure, I consider investigating and getting rid of it in case it turned out to be something dangerous, since it's so bizarre and all. But I hadn't the slightest idea how to go about it, so I decided to just keep an eye on that thing. Not to mention, David told me I was better off leaving it alone.
Oh. Oh, wie? Was? David weiß, was das ist. Ah, ich glaube, stimmt, das war in der... Ah, ich glaube, das war in dem einen Gespräch, was hatten.
Don't dismiss something before you've seen it's true nature, huh? Sure, if I did, I'd be no better than a Juno.
It was the same with me. I didn't know what it was, so I couldn't do anything about it. I could see that giant tree and the cube no matter where I went, but I had more pressing matters to attend to. Rather than bother with something I knew nothing about, I figured that my time would be better spent helping the people here who had been led astray by the unjust god.
That's very admirable of you, but are you sure it's okay to leave that village unattended?
They should be fine during the early yugas, especially while there are barely any Kali around. They have weapons now, even if the area has been assembled, and I've taught them how to fight as best as I can. They should be able to handle themselves in a pinch. The only thing I'm worried about right now are a sacred... There.
Die heiligen Biester wieder.
Verdammte Einhörner.
Reiß alle eure Ohren ab, Mann.
It's another pack of sacred beastmaster. Let's hide and wait for them to pass again.
Ah, it's not just a sacred beast. There's something else there, next to the road.
Wait, is that a person?
I'm not picking up any vital signs. I'm afraid it's a dead body. Perhaps they died of disease or in an accident.
Why are you going over to it?
Damn, we're too late.
Das war das, was Lakshmi schon gesagt. Wenn jemand stirbt, dann löschen sie ihn aus, dass wahrscheinlich alle hier ihn vergessen.
The body disappearing.
So I didn't know then, huh? That's one of this world's mistakes. The sacred beast purify the bodies of anyone who happens to die unexceptionally. My guess is the false god thinks that bodies don't belong to the world and wants them gone as soon as possible.
I see. So if this world was a single entity, the sacred beast are white blood cells of the immune system. Since we can assume the world's god would be the head, the sacred beast must be its macrophages created to detect, isolate and remove any foreign elements. So then, does that mean the Kali they fight or something like a virus? Most intriguing.
Whatever the case, people are people. One day they shouldn't be there cleaned up like trash. Their karma should be determined what they become in their next life. At least that's what my people believe. That's what a true samsara cycle is meant to be. We cremate dead bodies to free the souls and ensure they don't go on their next life without an issue. But here, as long as the sacred beasts are around, nobody will be able to hold a proper cremation. If this world has no respect for the journey of the dead and no hope for those who are left behind, then it is nothing but a world of death.
So that's why you were concerned about the sacred beast showing up in Deval. Because one of your elderly had passed away.
Right, he was an old man whose time had come. There's nothing anyone could do about that. But I didn't want to force God stealing our right to give him a proper farewell. You really helped us a lot there.
Aber an den Viechern müssen wir vorbei. Und das wird übel werden, weil da wird es wahrscheinlich noch ein paar mehr geben.
They're finally leaving.
If they haven't already spotted you, then I would urge you to hold back for now. You're almost still got Skyball, and I would very much prefer to avoid making a commotion wherever possible.
I know, I would have stopped them if I had found their body first, but I think that now my only choice is to let them go.
Wenn sie es natürlich gehen lassen.
We should be okay now. I'm certain the sacred beast can't detect us this far away. Good. I'm glad I didn't have to sneeze while we are hiding. Let's go. Wow, I knew she was cool and collected, but I knew she had such a charming sense of humor.
Ich hab so das Gefühl, wie sie sich beim letzten Mal verhalten hat, dass es kein Humor ist. Das ist der Büffel.
My. Seeing it this close up really makes you realize just how big it actually is, doesn't it? Oh, I've got an idea. Why don't we take a little group photo and commemorate the occasion? Pepe!
Was it a joke or were I just trying to avoid facing the reality of the situation? Either way, it wasn't funny.
If you want to pick, go ahead and take all the selfies you want. Just don't come running to me if the whole thing turns out to a jump scare. Foo foo foo!
Oh, you guys are no fun. I was just trying to lighten the mood a little.
So, these numbers we are seeing are accurate, right? Our sense aren't the fruits or anything, right? That's right. Imagine it's in an area near the cube before the problem. But...
Kalis. Damit wurden wir auch schon gewarnt.
Where did all these Kalis come from? I thought there were barely supposed to be any during the Kriter Yuga.
I think it's a place, not a time.
They're showing up as they thought they'd just been here all along, rather than coming off somewhere else. Be that as may, the sheer number of them is almost absurd. There are so many here as there were during the Kali Yuga, maybe even more.
Hey, I've got an idea. Why don't we just run away? Seriously.
Wie sie mit so einem ernsthaften Gesicht sagt.
You have a point. We can't investigate the cover of all this Kali around. Annoying since we just got here. If there's someone else, we'll have to nowhere to go.
True. We can take as many risks when it comes to safety. And there's certainly nothing to be gained by attempting to complete an impossible goal.
We're getting out here now.
Understood. We break for the Kali behind us and make a run for it. Waiting orders, Master.
Ach, liebe Leute, Mann. Jetzt waren wir schon hier bei dem wunderschönen Rubik's Cube und jetzt finden wir nicht was raus. Ein wenig enttäuschend. Aber das wurde ja im Endeffekt schon gesagt, dass die Gegend hier um den Würfel so gefährlich ist, weil da so viele von den kleinen Viechern rumlaufen. Und das hat sich halt jetzt hier nur bewahrheitet. So. Über Kalis. Alle plappern. Das wird jetzt ein sehr interessanter Kampf für mich. Ach, Gegner, okay. Weil ich würde gerne sehen... Ich habe jetzt nicht die beste CE. Ich hätte jetzt im Endeffekt hier Magical Girl of Sapphire nehmen können. Und mit Double Bright geht es ja auch. Ob wir in dem Fall Filter loopen können gegen Berserker. Ich bezweifle es nämlich, um ehrlich zu sein, aber ich würde es gerne testen. So. Wäre jetzt nämlich mal ganz interessant, das jetzt herausfinden. Wie gesagt, vom Damage mache ich mir jetzt sehr wenig Sorgen, aber eben vom Loop-Potential, weil Berserker, wisst ihr, sind ja immer ein bisschen madig zum Loopen wegen seltsamen Damage-Modifikatoren und das Übliche. Oh, der Damage passt. So, was hat sie befunden? 39, das langt locker. Für jetzt. Aber danach schon nicht mehr. Ne, wenn wir nicht Return farmen können. Schade. Mal jetzt muss ich das schon einsetzen. Oh nein, und der Arztbuff geht nicht. Nein. Vielleicht können wir ein bisschen anteasern. Schade. Sehr schade. Weil jetzt müsste sie theoretisch 60. Ja, also sie müsste 56% befassen und das schafft sie natürlich. Dafür hat sie jetzt, ja, aber auch mit dem Buff hat sie es nicht geschafft. Schade. Der hat halt das Problem an der blöden Viechern hier. Egal, dann machen wir es auf die atmosphärische Art und Weise. Bewegst aber einsetzen? Nein. So easy mache ich es euch nicht, meine Freunde. So, zack. Geht auch so, meine werten Herren. Glaubst du echt nicht, dass ich hier vor so einem kleinen Kali-Monster hier mich bezwingen lasse? Das ist übrigens das erste Mal, dass ich die bekämpfe, finde ich eigentlich ganz interessant. Einfach nur so vom Typ her, weil es ist immer nett, einen neuen Standardgegner zu treffen, die wahrscheinlich häufig auftauchen werden. Aber Leute, jetzt erstmal hier. Ich bin zu gewesen! So, aber das Einzige, was wir wahrscheinlich jetzt machen, ist hier abhauen. Sehr schade. Hätte mich sehr interessiert. Ich denke im Endeffekt, dieser Cube ist ja so eine Art Gefängnis, wäre so meine große Vermutung, dass da irgendwie vielleicht diese indischen Götter hier gefangen sind oder sowas in der Art. Wäre jetzt mal so ein Gedanke gewesen. Aber okay. Oh, danke, danke, danke. Nur noch 30 Stück oder so. Und wenn das mit Super Ryan nicht klappt, dann kann ich immer dann endlich mal hier anders leveln, so wie mein guten Asklepios. Ich glaube, ich weiß gar nicht, ob das braucht. Okay, I think that's enough distance between us and him. Oder, er schwört Hammer. I never imagined there would be that many Kali gathered here. I expected it might be dangerous, but with a number like that, adding one more to our ranks still won't be enough to fend them off. You don't have to rub it in. I wish my noble phantasm were capable of blasting them all the way at once, too. My apology. I assure you, I was not speaking sarcastically. I was merely reflecting on my failure to foresee the situation like this. I see. That's all. No, I'm sorry. I was being oversensitive. While we're on the subject, it seems to be a good chance to tell you this. Naturally, I'll do everything in my power to accomplish our mutual goal. I've no intention on holding back. But I should warn you, for your own safety, you shouldn't expect me to come through when it really counts. I've never truly been able to accomplish the things I most wish to do. That's just my lot in life. Well, it's a strange option to have for oneself. Perhaps a failure to defend a country in life had traumatic effect on her. Be that as may be, there is no doubt whatsoever that you are a far more useful combat than a detective in remote location. So I hope you will continue to lend Mr. Maxi your aid. Of course I will. I would be pleased if you trusted me on that much. At any rate, there are really a ridiculous number of Kali there. That's the impression that it may be even more important to the Thrust Belt than we thought. Indeed, it was as though these Kali were solely to guard the Sky Boulder. The fact that they can
no longer see them after putting just a slight distance between us and the Skyboulder would only seem to confirm that. I wonder what this could mean. For that matter, we still don't know what those Kali demons actually are. I'm guessing Holmes is probably right in that they are like a virus infecting this world in opposition of the sacred beast. But still, we have not the slightest idea what they were and where they came from or where they go. I don't know either, but I can say they are not any ordinary kind of creature. Given that they stick around even after the world has remade, maybe Arjuna uses them a means to determine who is the worth preserving. Or maybe they just remained here out of necessity. If it is all like that, that will mean they are a crucial part of the stage Arjuna uses to run this world. So, if we defeat him, maybe they'll all just go poof. I guess this means we just have to figure out what to do about Arjuna. At least we know not that the god Skyboulder is protected by a vast number of Kali and can't be approached lightly. It may not be much, but it is more than we knew before. In the meantime, I suggest we return to the well and plot our next course of action.
Oh nein, Leute, das heißt der dritte Kali-Tag. Oh nein, 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 der vierte. Oh mein Gott, wir sind ja schon wieder im schlimmen Kali, oder? Warte mal, schauen wir mal unsere kurze Uhr. Das mit der Uhr gefällt mir da oben voll. Das finde ich eine so coole Sache. Oh, Rats, dankeschön. Check one. Also okay, einen schönen Tag haben wir noch und danach wird es furchtbar wieder. Okay, dann lassen wir uns mal überraschen, wie es weitergeht. Beim nächsten Mal geht es dann weiter mit Fake and Runner. Und dann werden wir rausfinden, wie unser nächster Zug ist. Bis dann, haut rein, auf Wiedersehen, ciao.